This Sent 14 is by far my favorite set so far. Like, this is the first time that I'm actually playing Zero a bunch, like, in my free time. Even if I'm now back at work, I'm still, like, trying to find a little bit of time in between, you know, stuff when I'm waiting for something to load or whatever, just, like, sliding a quick game. Like, I haven't had this much fun, and it really takes me back to the fact that I think Set 13 was when my perspective on Vanguard changed, and it wasn't just, like, a simple game, I guess, but it became something more than that, something I wanted to dedicate my life to. And you know, it really takes me back to those times, and it's so damn fun. So I'm definitely full of glee and joy as I bring you this day one dex video for set 14. Also, before we get into the video itself, I wanted to actually give a huge thank you to y'all that just have been showing up throughout the entire year of 2020, you know, both on YouTube and on my Twitch. You guys really, you know, blew up my channel, all my everything I really do. You know, like, doing videos is like basically my passion. It's something that I think I'll be doing for the rest of my life, you know, in some shape or form as a hobby. And so the fact that so many of you have been coming through throughout all of 2020 and made my 2020 so special honestly means a lot to me. And like, you know, y'all have been coming through on the Twitch as well, you know, dropping follows, just like talking in general and just being cool. So honestly, huge thank you. I have like another kind of New Year's themed video coming up soon that I guess I should squeeze in a little, you know, thank you in, because I feel like this is something that should be repeated in a more New Year's themed video. But overall, just thanks, y'all. Thank you. Anyway, let's get into today's video. We're going to be taking a look at the day one decks for set 14. Of course, it is now day four, but, you know, day one still, it doesn't matter. So, we have a total of 8 decks to take a look at today. So we gotta blaze through this pretty quickly and not take too long, because I'm gonna be trying to do a video for each one of them. Maybe the Zerakil one I won't, but I'll try, I'll do my best. Anyway, we're gonna start from the most important DP. So these are the two DP lists I've been playing. They're both now fairly well tested, and chances are they will stay pretty similar for the actual Deccan fights. So this is the reverse Daisha build. So it's pretty straightforward. Reverse Daisha essentially lets you count almost one and lock two dimensional robos to give one of your bonus units minus 10k. If it's a rear guard that goes to zero, then you kill it. And then his other skill is when he attacks a 6,000 or less power Vanguard, he gets an extra crit. This is a very cool ability, but also it's kind of tricky to play against, because if your opponent is like on two and you break ride, then you still need to attack with the rear guard to put them on three. And then if they take a defensive and they go from 1 to 11 rather than 6, that extra crit fades away. It's a little bit awkward, but it's still a really good card. It's good for clearing intercepts too, so it's pretty nice. Of course, Daikaiser the break ride, you know, basically forces the opponent to PG with 2 PGs instead of 1, so usually finishes games pretty well. Die Hard is the key card for DP right now. When he attacks and his attack hits the Vanguard, if his power before the attack was 13k, you can put a great 3-dimensional robo from your hand into your soul to search your deck for any great 3-dimensional robo and ride it as rest. So they buffed this really, really hard. Used to be put 2-dimensional robo grade 3s from your hand into your soul, now just 1, so you can easily, like, you know, put a regular Daisha into your soul to go into a Daikaiser and then ride into the reverse Daisha to get the cross-ride status as well on top of that. Die Brave is good for drawing cards right here, and then the Go Cannon is good for adding extra crit, and of course the Mika is still very important for drawing cards. So that's Reverse Daisha. It's a pretty good deck, I would say. It's feeling very solid. I honestly think the regular Great Daisha feels better though, because you have to work less for that third crit. So, you know, for Reverse Daisha, you can actually, like, if you get unlucky, your opponent checks defensive, if they were on two, you just lose that extra crit from him. But Great Daisha always keeps that extra crit, so you'll always be swinging with the third crit and you don't have to work for it or anything. So you can play stuff like Laurel, you know, you can kind of like your entire, you can play more Mikas as well and like stuff like that. So like the deck itself, I think this one is pretty self-explanatory. It's just like, it's Great Daisha with Daikaisers and the new cards added in that we just talked about. And so especially Go Cannon is really good in this deck, because basically when you break ride you have 3 crit, and then after you break ride Great Daisha has only 2 crit, but you want to keep them at 3 for the entire game until they lose. So then you use Goyusha to give yourself the third crit by putting another dimensional robo into your soul while you have a Daisha Vanguard to give the Daisha an extra crit. So very cool. Also, Laurel comes in handy when you're sitting on Daikaiser and stuff like that, so that's also pretty good. I don't want to spend too much time talking about this, because I'll talk about it more depth in the actual Deccan fight. Aqua Force I've tested very little, just a few games. I've mostly been playing the two DP variants, Chaos and Blouse, so far. So, as of making this video, but throughout the month I'll be working on all these decks and playing them, so that way I can deliver more quality commentary on all of them, I guess. Anyway, Wheel of Assault is very important. After the battle he boosted, Kamos 1 swapped two rear guards with their spaces, so you can like put an attacker behind your Vanguard and then like swap attackers with behind your Vanguard so you can get an extra one up there. I run four tails still. This might reduce over time. Actually, Tidal Assault is really good in this deck because they buffed the Tetra Drive to basically say that when your rearguard attack ends, it is the fourth battle. So the nice thing is that you can basically go like rearguard swing into something, Vanguard swing into rearguard, and then Tidal Assault swing into Vanguard, and then Tidal Assault swing again. Or if they don't have an intercept, then you can go like rearguard swing to rearguard, Vanguard swing to Vanguard, Tidal Assault swing into Vanguard, Tidal Assault swing into the other rearguard, and then restand. So it's actually a really good deck, I think, overall. Like Tidal Assault and Tetra Drive are still both really good cards. People were pretty disappointed that Tidal Assault didn't get any buffs, but I think it's still a really good card, and Tetra Drive definitely is carrying. You can do two Transcore Dragon usages per turn when you break right over Tetra Drive because it restands. Glory is still an amazing finisher. I've won more games with Glory than Tetra Drive in all my time of playing this deck, so that's that. Also, Aqua Force has the counter chargers. That's also very cool. So yeah, then this is basically Zerakiel updated with new cards. So it's still the same Zerakiel deck that I have talked about in the past, but with Danielle added to basically add extra attacks. This way you can go like Hermier to call something, and then after, so basically you swing with one rear guard, then you swing with Hermier to Vanguard. Hermier procs to put herself in the damage zone, call something else out. Danielle sees that, and then she calls herself out to the other rear guard slot. So you basically get two attackers out of it, and that's all really nice. Even though she's two counterblast, you're always like unflipping counterblast by using the skills of Angel Feather, so you can still afford to use this pretty flexibly. And this is just a better no CL for Celestial, so there's no reason not to play it. So that one's pretty straightforward. Then we have Chaosbreaker. Chaosbreaker is still surprisingly really, really, really good. You know, all the nerfs, everyone was like, oh, the card is dead, the deck is dead, myself included, but Chaos is still amazing for zero standards because being able to pop rear guards and draw is of course good, even if it's a hard ones per turn. And the Kalamos 1 to discard 2 is probably still the heaviest part of it, but it's still good because it takes your opponent off guard because they expect you to be sitting on infinite zero, and you know they're like safe from any locks until they give them the 4 damage, but you just go into Chaos, block their front row that they try to push you with or whatever, or try to, you know, swing your rears with, and then you can start kind of snowballing from there. I personally like to use the Singularity Sniper, I think she's called, to, you know, when her attack hits the Vanguard, lock another rear guard. Sometimes, you know, if your opponent is being extra careless and they call a non-intercept front row, you can lock that too and start, you know, punishing their front rows as well. Colony Maker is a fantastic card. Unplaced Rear Guard Circle, if your opponent has a locked card, combos one, search your deck first, grade one or lower, Star Vader, and call it. So you can always search for the Palladium, who says at the start of your turn, combos one, put him into your soul, and you can choose an opponent's card that unlocked during their last end phase and lock it again. So basically, just refreshing that lock, which is an amazing skill to have as well. 10k attackers got added, and then 12k attackers also got added, but I kind of feel like having 10k vanillas is more important because if you lock their back rows, they basically are unable to, you know, swing into a 10k vanilla without a booster, and if they don't have 10k vanillas or 12k attackers themselves, then they won't be able to, so that's also very nice. Apart from that, not much in the list has really changed. Then we have Blouse. Oh my god, Blouse are fantastic. This deck is insane. Like, it can easily kill people from 3 to 6 with no problem. I think, like, it's even better than Ethics, in my opinion, honestly. Like, it feels even better than Ethics. So, the best thing about it is Morgenroth, the starter. So this guy says, when he boosts a Blau Vanguard and the attack hits the opponent's Vanguard, can almost one look at the top 3 cards of your deck and add a Blau to your hand. Yes, this does not go to soul. You can keep using this every turn. You have a grade 1 Blau PG, which you can search from these top 3. Searching a PG every turn sounds pretty great. You have a Blau 10k vanilla. You have a Blau that restands itself and gets 3k. You used to get 5k, so it got nerfed. But basically, when your Vanguard's Blau attack is the opponent's Vanguard, come us one, stand him, give him 3k. So you can search that. You have the regular Blau Kluger, who basically, if you boost this on Vanguard Circle with a starter, you get to use the starter first to check top 3, and then his skill of hitting the Vanguard countercharges that counter boss. So then you can still use, like, Mars, for example, to push some early aggro. Blaus have a 12k attacker, but it isn't Blau named, so be careful about that. And then, of course, our grade 3s. I'm running one Stern because he still kind of accomplishes the game plan. The game plan being to go into your break ride, which is Mon Blau Kluger, who, when you break ride over him, gives your Vanguard the skill, plus 10k, and then when your Vanguard attacks, Kamos 1, restand all of your rear guards, which is really good because, of course, Blau, Galaxy Blau Vulgar is restanding on the Vanguard Circle, so you can actually use the Break Right skill twice. So his skill is, once per turn when he attacks the Vanguard, give 5k, and the following skill, once per turn when your Blau attack hits a Vanguard. So when your Blau Rearguard or Blau Vanguard hits the opponent's Vanguard, count them as 2, discard 2, restand your entire middle column, and draw 2. So what you can do is swing with your 2 rear columns, then swing with a Vanguard, use the Breakride skill to restand your board, so including those rearguards that were attacking, and then you restand the Vanguard, and then you can swing with those rears again, swing with a Vanguard again, and use that Breakride skill again. Yes, it is 4 damage, 4 Cannibals to use, which is why we're using Claydol Mechanic to help us with that. Also, Dancing Wolf makes a great return because Dancing Wolf can now boost a 12k attacker to basically make a 22k column, or with a regular grade 3, it's a 21k column when restood by the Breakride's effect. Also, Yamato the Drake is still amazing because we're restanding all our rears, we can restand like a random 7k in the back to make a 21k column instantly. I'm still running one energy charger for the Soul Blast 2 and draw 1 because it's good, and we usually have about that much soul to actually do the Soul Blast. Then I have not tested it whatsoever, so this is the deck I haven't tested like at all. This is Ramiel Reverse, so it's the Celestial deck but with Ramiel Reverse, who basically she gets extra power when anybody's card damage zone card goes to the drop zone. So you know, when somebody heals or somebody's card gets sent to the drop zone, so if you're in an Angel Mirror, I guess that's gonna get a lot of buffs. If you actually, I guess there's not much rescue style cards though that like actually send cards from the damage zone to the drop zone, so I guess it won't be happening that much. Anyway, her limit break is lock 2 Celestials for that turn. Your front row, 3 front row Celestials get plus 5k power, and then your opponent has to randomly put a back row priority rear guard into the damage zone, then choose a random card from their damage zone, prioritizing face ups, I think, face ups, and put in the drop zone, so that triggers her plus 5k. She's a cross ride with the break ride as well, so that's pretty nice. But apart from that, it's like, I haven't tested it, so I really can't say much. This is just like my first draft build, so this will definitely, I mean, either be adjusted or have a very in-depth explanation once I actually get to playing it. And finally, Zeal is got some really good support too with the break ride of Zero, who basically when you break ride gives 10k and then minuses 8k from one of your opponent's units, and then as always if a rear guard went to zero gets retired, and then if you the Vanguard you break ride into is an alien, you can search your deck for an alien. So what aliens can we search? This alien says, when his attack hits a 6k or lower unit, you get to draw a card for free. Very nice. You can also hit like your opponent's grade 1s in the front or whatever, so it's also really good. We can search, you know, the grade 2 Zeal is an alien. This is an alien. When placed rear guard circle for that turn, one of your opponent's units loses 2k. Very good. Again, Zeal is an alien. This Seahorse is an alien. When placed rear guard circle, Soul Blast 1. For that turn, opponent's unit loses 3k power. That's also nice. On top of that, Zeal itself is an alien. And let's not forget this 12k attacker, but most importantly, Laurel is an alien for whatever reason. So you can just search out Laurel, and that's also very, very cool. Still running Daisha's Heals because, you know, it's just a great card with the banish to get one of 4 random cards into your hand. But then, of course, Zeal is still the main moneymaker in this deck, you know, being able to just decrease your opponent's units to 0 after you've dealt a bunch of minus powers with the other cards in the deck. So the deck, I've faced it in ranked already a couple times. It felt solid, nothing too fantastic, but pretty solid. But I'll probably make an updated Zeal deck because this is the last time I get support until like G. So, you know, it's gonna be a while, but it'll be fun to play with, you know, all the memes aside. I still think Zeal is pretty fun in its own right. But yeah, so that is actually it for this day one decks video. So a lot of decks, a lot of cool decks. I think in terms of what I'm excited about is like both DP decks I've played a lot with. Aqua Force I'm excited to playtest more. Chaos playtest more. Blau's play even more. And then the Angels and Zeal as well. I will get to eventually, but probably in the latter half of the month. I still have a couple Deccan fights from last set that need to come out. So Great Nature will come out first. I already recorded that a while ago. And then I recently finished Battle Sisters by accident. So that I need to record at some point. But I might actually push that one a little bit to after I'm done with the set 14 ones. And then if I have a bit of time, I will finish up the last of the set 13 ones, being the updated Battle Sisters. So that should be pretty fun in its own right. But on that note though, that's gonna be it for me today. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. I personally really enjoyed this set, and this meta feels really good. Everything just feels fresh. A lot of viable decks from both previous sets and the current set, and it's just, it's really, really nice. It's really fun to play Zero right now, and I think this is one of the better sets that Vanguard Zero has had. You know, I don't say this very often, I really don't, but I'm really enjoying this, and I feel like I will be playing a lot of these decks even in future sets too, which is, again, not something I often say. But anyway, on that note, that is going to be it for me today. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye.